Good morning, students. The last class we discussed up to Chinese civilization. In this Chinese civilization, we discussed about their empire and their administration and how they became a civilized society. And also we discussed about the philosophy and literature, some of the philosophers, their religions and Chinese script. And finally, we discussed about the contribution of the Chinese civilization to the world. Today, we are going to discuss about Indus civilization. So, Indus Valley civilization is one of the most important civilization in the world. So, it is one of the earliest civilization of the world. So, the Indus civilization, also known as the Harappan civilization. Harappan civilization, it covers an area of over 1.5 million square kilometers in India and Pakistan. In the present, the Indus Valley civilization is situated in the both countries, Pakistan and India. Sutkarjan Dor in the west of the Pakistan Iran border, Sot Tugai in Afghanistan is the northern Alam Girbur in Uttar Pradesh, in the eastern Daimabad in Maharashtra, in the south are the boundaries in which the Harappan culture has been formed. So the present countries of Pakistan and Afghanistan and India, along the three Indian countries, this civilization flourished. Its main concentration is in the regions of Gujarat, Pakistan, Rajasthan and Haryana. The Indus civilization, the Indus cities mainly concentrated in the following regions, the present Gujarat, Pakistan, Rajasthan and Haryana. In this region has a number of sites of Indus culture in India. Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, Dholavira, Kalibangan, Lothal, Banavali, Ragikari and Surkotada are the major cities of the Indus civilization. So these are the major cities of Indus civilization. We discussed about the Harappa. So Harappan civilization in Punjab and Pakistan, the present Punjab, Indian Punjab and near the countries of Pakistan. Mohenjo-daro also situated in the Sindh and Pakistan. Dholavira is in Gujarat and Kalibangan is in Rajasthan in India. So Lothal, it is a largest civilization, so it is situated in Gujarat. The major cities of the Indus civilizations are fortified cities. Fortification one. So all of the cities of the Indus civilization has the fortification. Well-planned streets and lanes and drainages can be observed in the Harappan towns. The Harappans used baked and unbaked bricks. So Harappan used baked and unbaked bricks. It is one of the urban civilization. It's not a rural civilization. All the houses and buildings of the Harappans are constructed only in the baked and unbaked bricks. The Harappan used the baked and unbaked bricks and stone for the construction. The present also we are using stone. Likewise, the Harappans used stones. A civic authority perhaps controlled the planning of the towns. A few of the houses had more than one floor. More than one floor. That means every houses of the Harappans has a one floor. The few houses had more than one floor. The tank called the Great Bath at Mohenjo-daro. There was a common bath that is called Great Bath that was in Mohenjo-daro. It is one of the important structure and well paved with several adjacent rooms. The Great Bath has rooms to change their cloth. And granary also discovered in the Mohenjo-daro. Through these two buildings, we can know the techniques of the architecture of Indus people. They must have had a political organization at the level of an early form of state. A male image from Mohenjo-daro has been identified as the priest king. One image was discovered that is called priest king. It is a male image, but we do not know about the accuracy of this interpretation. So second one, we are going to discuss about the agriculture and animal domestication. The Harappans practiced agriculture. They cultivated wheat, barley and various types of millets. So wheat and barley was their main food, and they also practiced various types of millets. They adopted a double cropping system. Today also we are using the double cropping system. Likewise, they used the double cropping system was also known to them. The pastoralization. The pastoralization means the some part of the society they were shepherd. They reared cattle, sheep and goats. They had knowledge of various animals including elephant but did not use horse. The Harappan peoples knew the other animals, but they did not know about the horse. The Harappan's cattle are called zebu, and it is a large bird often represented in their sails. It's a Harappan cattle. That means the Harappan cattle is looking like a bull. It is called zebu. Second one is pottery. The Harappan used printed pottery. Their potteries have a deep red slip and black paintings. That means they used black and red ware potteries. The potteries has shapes like dish on stands, storage jars, perforated jars, goblets, S-shaped jars, plates, dishes, bowls and pots. They painted motifs generally noticed on the pottery's typical pipal tree leaves, fish scale design, intersecting circles, zigzag lines, horizontal bands and geometrical motifs and floral and faunal patterns. So these are the things painted on the pottery's. Most of the pottery's depict pipal tree leaves. The metal tools and weapons. The Harappan used jet blades, copper objects and bone and ivory tools. They did not possess knowledge about iron. So here the Harappan people only used the metals like copper. They did not know about the iron. The tools and equipment such as points, chisels, needles, fish hooks, razors, weighing pans, mirrors and antimony rods were made of bronze. The chisel made out of rory jet were used by the Harappans. The Harappans also used some weighing measures. They used some of the fishing hooks, chisel, needles. These all the weapons only made up of bronze, not in iron. Their weapons included arrows, spears, a chisel bladed tools and axes. The bronze image of dancing girl from Mohenjo-daro is suggestive of the use of lost wax processes. Mohenjo-daro dancing girl figure was discovered in Mohenjo-daro. It's one of the beautiful one. So from this we can know the techniques of melting and making the objects. Rohri chet refers to the chet raw material collected from Rohri in Pakistan. So Rohri in Pakistan. So this type of the chet is discovered here from Pakistan. That is why it's named Rohri chet. It was used by the Harappans for making blades. We can know that the Harappans used both stone and bronze tools. So from the early age, that means from the prehistoric period, people used stone tools. Likewise, the Harappan also used stone tools and bronze tools. And next, come to the textile and ornament. The Harappans used metal and stone ornaments. They had knowledge of cotton and silk textiles. So if you come to the textile, the Harappan used silk and cotton cloths, and they knew the techniques of making textile. They made carnelian, copper and gold ornament. Carnelian is a stone. From this they used or they made beads, stone beads. It's one of the precious stone. Fancy stoneware and shell bangles were also used. We can classify it here. So the shell bangles were also used, and another side, gold ornaments also used. The gold ornaments were used by the rich people and the royal people, but here the shell bangle were used by the common people, ordinary people. Some of them had its designs, and the Harappan exported them to Mesopotamia. So we discussed about the Mesopotamian civilization here. In this Mesopotamian civilization, we can know the trade and exchange of Mesopotamians and Indus people. So here the Harappans exported the ornaments and textiles to the Mesopotamia and other important civilizations. So these are the things the people used. So another one is trade and exchange. The Harappan had a close contact with the Mesopotamians. Mesopotamians, it is one of the most important trading center. So we had means the Harappans had a close trade contact with the Mesopotamians. Harappan seals have been found in the West Asia sites, namely Oman, Bahrain, Iraq and Iran. The cuneiform inscriptions mention the trade contact between Mesopotamia and the Harappans. The cuneiform inscription. Cuneiform is a writing. So it is a one of the script. This script inscriptions mentioning the trade contact between Mesopotamia and the Harappans. The mention of Meluha in the cuneiform inscription is considered to refer to the Indus region. So here the Meluha is one of the civilization. So means a cuneiform inscription. So here there was a cuneiform inscription was discovered. So this inscription considered to refer the Indus region. So from this Meluha civilization and this inscription, we can know the and measure the Indus region. Okay children, today's class is over. You are asked to complete your assignment by clicking the link below. Thank you.